It's rolling.
Broad Street.
Yeah, we downtown Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just come out here to preach the word. I'm just going to start with Proverbs. First, we're going to give all praises to Yahweh Bah, Shem Yahweh Shai.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Honors to the apostles, the elect, you know what I'm saying? The elders.
You guys, though.
I know you somewhere.
What school you go to?
ECA.
Who?
ECA.
ECA, what's that?
Early college coming. Well, I know you though, bro. You know me too.
You go to Premier? You still go to Premier?
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, what's up? I don't even know, I forgot.
Yeah.
You guys had dreads or something?
Nah, I'm single.
Yeah, what's up? Oh, we're teaching the Bible. Yeah.
Let me read you a scripture, bro.
I gotta catch the bus.
Gotta get one scripture.
Man, I gotta catch the bus.
All right, man.
You gotta catch the bus. This dude crazy. Bugged the fuck out. He bugged out on this. He wasn't acting like that before.
Maybe, you know, people act different when they out in public and shit.
Look at this dude. This dude violent.
Sorry, let's focus. Motherfuckers is crazy. You can't be distracted. Proverbs 29:1. He that being often reproved, harden his neck and shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. So yeah, so the Lord commanded us to come out here and teach the scriptures to reprove our people because they're not following the commandments of the Most High. They're not doing what the Lord said. They eat pork, celebrating Christmas, just running around acting like some heathens. So that's why the Lord said, that's why we're supposed to correct them. He that being often reproved, harden his neck, and shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. That's why the Lord said he's going to destroy 2/3 of our people of the nation of Israel, because they want to follow after the ways of the heathen. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
They want to worship their slave masters, and they good with living in America. They good with all this bullshit out here. They're not out here protesting this wicked-ass world. Proverbs 29:2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked beareth rule, the people mourn. And that's why everybody out here is mourning. Everybody's broke. You got no money. You know what I'm saying?
Stressed.
The cops are pulling you over, giving you tickets, taking your money. Cops is shooting you, killing you. You know what I'm saying? They forcing your children to go to the Columbus food system. Teaching you all kind of lies. That's how we know this government is not righteous. It's not of the Most High. God does not love America. God is going to destroy America because America is the kingdom of Satan. Right. America is the country where they legalize homosexuality and faggots can get married. Adultery is legal. Women are allowed to commit adultery. When according to the Bible, the punishment for adultery is death. But in America, adultery, that's part of popular culture. Most of these women done made pornos and had sex with 2,000 men. Proverbs 29:2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked beareth rule, the people mourn. That's how you know America's the kingdom of Satan. Because in America, homosexuals can get married, but a man can't have two wives. Tell me, that's some faggot shit.
That's fucked up.
Ain't it?
Yeah.
It's okay to be a transgender, be a freak, but a man can't have more than one wife. You can actually go to jail for it. Right. Here you go, check this out. Whoso, this is Proverbs 29:3. Whoso loveth wisdom rejoiceth his father, but he that keepeth company with harlots spendeth his substance. That's why you messing with these whores out here.
Yeah.
Because these whores only got one thing on their mind, and that's your money. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what they're going to get. They just going to use you. If you got a good job, you're going to get all kind of women. Yep. But if you broke, you ain't going to have no women. If you married and lose your job, your wife is going to leave you.
Yeah.
And she's gonna go fuck somebody else.
That's Hosea 4, I think. No, Hosea 4:1,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, but in America, it's legal. In a righteous kingdom, a woman would never be able to leave you. You know what I'm saying? That'd be against the law. That's Let me get that scripture real quick. In Leviticus. Just to prove it. That's how you do. This is a wicked place we live in, man.
It scripture says, hold up. Said the woman is like, she says, I will go after my lover because he provides for me pretty much my food and my drink.
That's what it said right here, the substance.
Yeah.
Let me get this real quick. Leviticus 20 and 10. And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death. So that means if your wife went and got with another dude, she's supposed to get put to death. Both of them are supposed to get put to death. You know what I'm saying? Just like what O.J. Simpson did. Because O.J. Simpson, what he did was a righteous act. We always talk about that. Because that's a good example of what happens to an adulterer and an adulteress. What's up, my dude? We'll get back. Where's he at? Proverbs 29. We'll read that again. Whoso loveth wisdom rejoiceth his father, but he that keepeth company with harlots spendeth his substance. So yeah, these women, man, they gonna take you for everything. And these women out here are grimy. You know what I'm saying? They grimy as hell.
That's Sirach 9. Yeah.
What's that? Which one?
Sirach 9:1. That's fucked up though. That's really fucked up.
It is fucked up.
Women trying to. The only thing they really worry about is the size of your dick and your money.
They don't give a fuck about your dick. All they want is your money.
Yeah.
These bitches, man. They got a big giant. I ain't gonna talk about it. They got giant ass dildo collections at home. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They be doing all kind of freaky shit. I don't even want to talk about it. It's nasty. Did you say 9?
Yeah.
Ecclesiasticus of Sirach 9, chapter 9, verse 1. Be not jealous over the wife of thy bosom, and teach her not an evil lesson against thyself. Give not thy soul unto a woman to set her foot upon thy substance. Yeah, so that's why you got these pussy whip men out here. They let their wife handle the checkbook and the accounts, the bank accounts and all that. Nah, that's not how it goes. And she's lucky she gets an allowance. I mean, you'll give her an allowance, you know what I mean? Like, you get this much. The man is in charge of that, not the woman. You don't want to leave a woman in charge of finances. She's going to spend everything. She's going to buy a new car every week. You know, buying new shoes. Next, you bankrupt and homeless before you know it.
Shit, she's going to be spending money on trying to make the house look nice when you started.
Right? And then as soon as you suck dry, she sucked all your substance dry, she's going to go get with another dude. She's going to move on to the next one. Leech him dry and move to the next one. That's how they do it. Fucking sluts, man.
Fucking nasty bitch.
Ecclesiasticus 9:3. Meet not with a harlot, lest thou fall into her snares. So yeah, you don't want to fall into the snares of one of these hoes out here. You know what I'm saying? You have you all fucked up. Then you be committing adultery, you fucking with this bitch. She already got three other boyfriends. If they find out about you fucking her, now they want to kill you. Because that's why in the righteous kingdom, adultery will be punishable by death. You know what I'm saying? A woman is only supposed to have one husband her whole life. That's the laws of the Bible. They ain't doing that in America. Verse 4. Use not much the company of a woman that is a singer, lest thou be taken with her attempt. I like that Rihanna bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's the devil.
Singing smooth to you and
singing
shit.
Singing smooth. Yeah, oh, you definitely don't want to be no with a woman, no singer. She be up in the clubs and the bars every night singing. Yeah. Man, she's fucking everybody.
She got talent, so she gonna use that talent on multiple niggas.
She's on, everybody wants to get with her. She's the most popular woman in town.
That's what they used to do back in the day. The prostitutes would fuck them and they used to sing to them, to the soldiers and shit.
Yeah, you know, like back in ancient Rome even, singers were looked down upon. And actresses and stuff were looked down upon because they were also, like you just said, it was also prostitutes too. You could get with them, they sing for you, service you. That should be common sense shit, though. Because you got a lot of Captain Sabahos out here. You know what I'm saying? They'll just be. That's what they are, Captain Sabahos. They always want to swoop through and save a hoe. You know, all you can't talk about our women like that. They're precious and beautiful. These bitches ain't beautiful. A pussy that's ridden with herpes and warts and all kind of shit. That's not beautiful. Bitch done been in 200 pornos. You know what I'm saying? That's not beautiful.
A pussy little.
You're walking down the street, you can see her pussy, camel toe. She got tattoos on her titties. She's got a tramp stamp on her buttocks right above her ass. What, wearing, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's not beautiful, man.
A pussy look like Joe.
That's living like a degenerate. He said pussy look like what? Our people are degenerates. You know
like
what I mean?
Job and shit.
They're degenerates. Our people are falling to a state of decay. You know what I'm saying? They smell like rotten swine's flesh. Let me get this. That's, the pussy be stinking too. Where was that? Verse 5. This is on Ecclesiastes 8 and 5. Gaze not on a maid that thou shall fall by those things that are precious in her. Give not thy soul unto harlots, which is whores, that thou shalt let me read that again, I'm stuttering. Give not thy soul unto harlots, that thou lose not thine inheritance. There it goes again, you're gonna lose all your shit. She gonna get you for everything. It, like I said, then she gonna divorce you. Cause you, especially these hoes out here, they always want you to put a ring on their finger. Rings in the fingers ain't nowhere in the Bible. There's not a single person put a ring on anybody's finger in the Bible. And, never happened.
And you got fucking bow down to her.
That's Norse paganism. That's what the Norse did. They put rings on the fingers. Oh yeah, the man got to bow down and propose to the woman.
That's fucked up.
No, the woman's supposed to bow to the man. Yeah. Like in that movie Coming to America with Eddie Murphy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? How the African queens or whatever was treating him.
That's what I thought.
That's how you're supposed to be. You bow on your knees, bark like. If I tell you to bark like a dog, bitch, you're going to bark like a dog.
Jump on one leg and shit.
Exactly. And you should be. I wouldn't make him do that, but.
Shit, I would. Just for the fun of it.
It would be fun.
For the black bitch. Revenge.
Yeah, so women's supposed to be. I got a scripture to back that up. A woman is supposed to be the servant of a man. It even tells you that in the book of Genesis.
Yeah.
It said the Lord created the woman to be man's helpmeet. But people, this should be common sense though. But our people are so dumb, they so far gone. They don't know shit from apple butter. You know what I mean? Like the old saying, they don't know their ass from a hole in the ground. Yeah. They just retarded. They've been following the ways of Esau. What was I saying? Oh yeah, Peter. Peter, where we at? Not special.
Oh shit.
So this is a script. If you got a girl at home, yeah, read her description. She'll kick you out of the house.
Yeah.
You get kicked out.
You gone.
Yeah, so you should. You would get kicked out. 1 Peter 3 and 1. Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own husbands, that if any obey not the word, they also may without the word be won by the conversation of the wives. Oh, these women always gossiping. They telling your wife's friends is always whispering in their ears, you need to leave him. He ain't no good. He ain't good for you. You know what I'm saying? They always encouraging adultery. 1 Peter 3 and 2. While they behold your chaste conversation coupled with fear, whose adorning, let it not be the outward adorning of plaiting the hair in a wearing of gold or a putting on of apparel. That you can't tell that to these women. They all decked out. They got gold earrings, nose ring. They got it all, bro. That's all they care about is looking good. They don't know how to dress modest. They gotta have titties popping out all over the place, just looking like a porn star. You know what I'm saying? They don't know how to look like a nice young lady. Dressing modestly, wearing a dress that covers her body. You know what I'm saying? Walking, keeping her head covered. Look, bitches is hoes. They ain't gonna do a hoe. Ain't gonna do that. 1 Peter 4. But let it be the hidden man of the heart, in that which is not corruptible, even the ornament of a meek and quiet spirit, which is in the sight of God a great price. Yeah. So you ain't gonna see none of these too many of these women in a meek and quiet spirit. What's up? A woman's supposed to have a meek and quiet spirit. That's the kind of wife you want. A woman who's, you know, it ain't out of order. Run around yelling, acting crazy, dancing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Grinding, yelling, screaming, cursing out her man, making a fool of herself in public. You know what I mean? Always fighting, wanting to fight, acting like a man. Because these women are an embarrassment. First Peter 3:5. For after this manner in the old time the holy women also who trusted in God adorned themselves, being in subjection unto their own husbands. The woman's supposed to be in subjection to her husband. But in this society, you ain't got that. If you yell at a woman, since we live in Satan's kingdom, she can call the cops on you. Just for she'll call the cops just for yelling at her. And the cop will come through and save a hoe. You know what I mean? You're not even allowed to put your own house in order out here.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
You know what I'm saying? This kingdom's out of order. This is Satan's kingdom. That's why the Lord's going to destroy America. Because it goes against the word of the Most High. This is an anti-Christ nation. Everything in this Bible is designed to be against the Bible. What did I say? Everything in this world, excuse me. It's like... you get tongue twisted sometimes. You know what the fuck I meant. Is somebody be on the comboard? See? Yeah, everything in this world is designed to go against the Bible. This is Satan's kingdom. I'm getting a preset real quick. Get a revelation. Revelation. Revelation 2:13. I know thy works and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is, and thou holdest fast my name and hast not denied my faith, even in the days wherein Antipas was my faithful martyr, who was slain among you where Satan dwelleth. And this was written, this is Revelation written by the Apostle John while he was imprisoned by the Romans on the Isle of Patmos. In America is the modern day Roman Empire, okay? In the Lord right here, he said, I know where you dwell is, where Satan's seat is, where Satan's throne is. Satan sits on his throne in America. And this is the country where the kingdom of Satan was founded. The kingdom of Satan. America is the country where the church of Satan was founded. The church of Satan was founded by Anton LaVey in San Francisco in America. But they say America's a God-fearing nation. You know that's a lie. If that was the truth, then all them devil worshipers should get put to death, get burned at the stake, get hung, get stoned to death. Right?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
What does the Bible say in the Old Testament? If you got a wizard or something, you're supposed to kill him.
They gone.
You're supposed to put wizards to death. But now in America, they make movies about wizards. They make it cool. They got little encouraging your children. Wizards with movies like Harry Potter. You be watching the Montel Williams show. He got that psychic bitch talking to spirits on TV. What was that? I forget her name. You know who I'm talking about. Montel Williams? The Montel Williams? Montel?
Yeah, I heard him. But shit, the little kid shows like Nick Jr. and Disney Channel, whatever. Every goddamn thing on there is about witchcraft and magic and shit.
Let me get a scripture for that.
They call them Lord. I got a show called Lord Charmers or whatever.
Yeah, I seen that.
It's something. It's some ugly ass little thing. It's I forgot his name. Wally Kazam or some shit.
Wally Kazam.
Yeah, yeah. My sister, you know.
You know that word abracadabra?
What?
You know that, you know how they always get your children saying abracadabra?
Yeah.
And they did in the cartoons and everywhere?
Yeah.
That, even Aleister Crowley wrote about the word abracadabra. That's a real, like, word you use to summon up demons and do magic and shit. I've read it in Aleister Crowley's own book. But I done read all of his books, like, years ago.
Shit, that's, man.
He's one of the biggest devil worshippers in history. What? I got a scripture. Hold on.
Think you fuck.
Fucking piece of shit phone.
My finger's gone.
Alright, I got one. Leviticus 20 and 27. A man also, or woman, that hath a familiar spirit, or that is a wizard, shall surely be put to death. They shall stone them with stones, their blood shall be upon them. Oh, did y'all know, what's this raggedy-ass bus go by?
Piece of shit.
Oh, yeah, it was on the news that Hillary Clinton, that bitch, she held a seance in the White House, and they said she was summoning up the spirit of Eleanor Roosevelt. Even Obama referenced it, was making jokes about it. So according to the Bible, that's punishable by death. Leviticus 20 and 27. A man also, a woman that hath a familiar spirit, or that is a wizard, shall surely be put to death. They shall stone them with stones, their blood shall be upon them. Oh, that's why, like we was talking about, Hollywood makes all kind of movies for children about wizards and magic. That's because they're a bunch of devil worshippers. Because Hollywood's ran and controlled by the so-called Jews. And the so-called Jew is not a Jew. They're actually Edomites, because the real Jews are so-called black people. Okay? But the so-called Jews in the state of Israel, they're a bunch of devils, a bunch of cocksuckers, a bunch of faggots. And the Lord's going to put them all in slavery under the nation of Israel. But anyway, Hollywood is all controlled by Jews. And the word Hollywood means holy wood. Wood that was made from the holly.
Go, keep going.
What the hell? She gonna get broke. Yeah, but the word Hollywood means holy wood. Because the magical wands, you know, a magic wand that a wizard uses is made from the holly. You know what I'm saying?
Holly Grove.
So that. Because Hollywood is a form of magic. They use all these movies and TV shows to alter people's perception of reality. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They use all these movies to brainwash you. That's why all these movies got faggots in it. They got adultery in it. All these movies got atheist points of views in it. This is all kind of propaganda and brainwashing used to alter your perception of the world. And that's what you call magic. Because when you cast, how do you cast a spell on somebody? To cast a spell on somebody, you spell. To spell something means you spell out words. You use words. And that's how they manipulate your mind, is with those words that they speak. And that music they play in the movies. They alter your perception with the false news that they put on TV. People still watching Fox News and CNN. You know what I'm saying? All that shit's fake. They lying to you every chance they get.
Cartoon Network.
Yeah, the Cartoon News Network. They you sitting there watching TV and they casting spells on your ass, using all kinds of witchcraft on you. And that's the truth. This sounds crazy, but that's the truth. It even came out that your dude, what's that faggot's name that works for CNN? The blonde-haired faggot, the white-haired faggot.
I don't know.
That top man, I forgot. I can't remember his name right now. But he's a CIA agent. Anderson Cooper. That's his name. Anderson Cooper. He's a CIA. He's open with it. Yeah, he works for the CIA. And that's a Central Intelligence Agency. They're known for running all kind of scandalous operations. You know what I'm saying? That's what CNN is. CNN is a government-ran propaganda tool used to brainwash people and to control your mind, feeding you nothing but bullshit. And all these news networks are all owned by the so-called Jews, the devil. The devil himself, Esau.
That's how you brainwash him. The CIA was doing that, like, in 1900 or some shit. They was, how you brainwash somebody, you keep on repeating the same shit to the person.
Yeah, you say the same shit over and over.
And you start that from a
even
child.
Even Eric Holder said that. Eric Holder said we need to brainwash people about guns. You know, over and over again, we need to make them think that guns are the worst thing on the planet Earth.
Yeah.
And he actually said that we need to brainwash them over and over again. Oh, that's why Obama just came out today and said that he's going to start restricting the sale of guns. So there's going to be a civil war coming. The people ain't going to be having that. You know what I'm saying? You know, the new law now says if you want to sell a gun to anybody, you got to have a license. That means I can't even give you a gun or sell you one that
that's
I got. I got to have a license
to
do a background check.
That's it.
So that's bugged out and crazy. So soon they're going to come and try to take everyone's guns. There's going to be civil war. There's going to be riots in the streets. The riots already started. They burnt down goddamn Baltimore. They burnt that bitch to the ground. So, soon they're going to... Columbus going to get burnt to the ground. There's going to be chaos out here. There's going to be people killing each other. Cops is going to be killing people. Cops going to be getting killed. There's going to be a bloodbath. All the EBT cards are all going to get shut off. There ain't going to be no food on the shelves. People going to fight and kill each other over the last can of spinach. People, they'll kill each other over a can of dog food.
Yeah.
Get the last can of cat food. Yeah. That's ain't going to be no more food. That's what they're going to be eating. It's going to be beautiful. I'm going to get that.
Before you, what do they call them? The preppers?
Yeah, the preppers.
Yeah,
they going to get got. I mean, the only thing that's going to save you on that day is the Most High.
Yeah, because the government, they going to go in your shit and take your food. If they got a shortage on food, they got to take everybody's food and put it together and shit.
Oh, they'll do that. They'll force you. Yeah, they probably will.
And they're going to take your... And they're probably going to take you, you know.
Because that's what the government does. Like during World War II, or I'm not exactly sure the exact year. Not World War II, it was during the Great Depression when Franklin Roosevelt, he had the Gold Seizure Act. Where he said, everybody in the whole country, you got to turn your gold in. Turn all your gold in or you're going to jail. But hold up. Man, you got Donald Trump saying they're going to make America great again. When was it great? The government, the years Americans ago, back in the so-called good old days, that was supposed to be the good old days.
Yeah.
But if a government robbed everybody of their gold, you know what I'm saying?
That's fucked up.
What kind of shit is that?
Oh, shit, speaking of when was it, like 2 days ago or whatever, that America's fucking sell-off or whatever was like the worst in...
Oh, yeah, the stock market crashed like... A few hundred points on Monday. It was crashing more today. That's good, though.
And Puerto Rico's fucking up. Brazil's about to get...
The whole world's crashing.
Yeah.
Because it all started with China.
That's just getting crazy out of this month.
Yeah, nobody got no money. The unemployment rate is high as fuck. They're not even telling y'all the real unemployment rate. Okay, they said, I think, over half, almost nearly half the country's on EBT food stamps.
Sorry.
They depend on the government to eat. Without the government, most people in this city wouldn't even be eating. You'd be starving. And they could just cut it off like, pow.
Yep.
Gone. You starving. Now there's riots and chaos. That's what's going to happen. It's going to happen. Because the dollar is worthless. The whole economy is about to collapse. And then there ain't going to be no food. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And there's going to be death.
What you going to do with no food? Yeah, look at you.
Tonight, bro.
Yeah, hey.
What the fuck?
Oh, he gonna stop for this nigga, though. That's fucked up. It's cool, though. You march for destruction, you know what I'm saying?
What was I about to get? Have a quick one here.
Niggas had tickets.
Damn. Let me get this apple cook.
I ain't trying to get this nigga on. Man.
Apple cook? Oh, actually, I want this, not apple cook. Nahum 3:1. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not. So the bloody city, that's talking about America. Woe to America. The Lord's going to destroy America. America is a country of lies and robbery. The government take all your money. Cops will pull you over, give you tickets, make you go to court. take you for everything. You got paying taxes. They take half your check before you even get it. And don't pay your taxes. They won't come after you with guns and put you in prison. So we live in a state of total control. Everybody, you all, essentially we all slaves. Nahum 3:1. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not. The noise of a whip and the noise of a rattling of the wheels of a whip. They even call cars whips, don't they?
Yeah.
Well, and that's the whip back then, whip the horse.
Yeah.
So that's probably where they got that from. Got the whip, you know what I'm saying? You rolling in the whip. They still use that word?
Yeah, sometimes.
I don't know. I'm not.
Well, not really.
I'm not up on shit. The noise of a whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheels. Yeah, you hear all this noise and the rat. It's a bunch of noise. A bunch of noise pollution. All these loud ass buses and trucks and all these cars and all this shit. It's a bunch of noise and confusion. The noise of a whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheels. You know, the prancing horses and the jumping chariots. You got cars jumping on, you know, all this bullshit out here, man.
Yeah.
The horseman lifts both bright sword and a glittering spear, and there's a multitude of slain and a great number of carcasses, and there is none enter their corpses. They stumble upon their corpses. Oh, yeah, so when that war comes, you're going to have them war chariots coming through, like them tanks, the Humvees, that tracks. You know what I'm saying? Now they got planes. We dropping bombs on drones. They gonna get y'all with drones. Shoot your ass with a drone.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Robots.
Oh, they got robots. DARPA got robots so they'll hunt you down, kill you, and eat you. No, they eat you. That's how they fuel. The robot can fuel itself with biomaterial. It would body it. Like, they can eat plants or flesh.
That's creepy.
And it'll give fuel to the robot.
That's creepy. That's creepy right there.
Well, they got nuclear powered drones now to run on nuclear power.
Even.
All right, bingo.
What's that? And there is none in the. And so, when the Lord brings that death and destruction, like the scriptures say, there's going to be none in of their corpses. They stumble upon their corpses. There's going to be so many dead bodies, you're going to be tripping over them.
Can't wait for fucking.
There'll be arms and legs, blood and guts, eyeballs splattered everywhere.
Fuckers, man, without remedy.
There's going to be no remedy. You ain't gonna be no cure for that death, for that disease. Because America is a sin. This country is like a cancer. You know what I'm saying? The only way you get rid of cancer, you gotta kill it.
Or it will kill
they
you.
They be trying to send cancer patients to get some radiation therapy. But the Lord gonna get your ass with some thermonuclear destruction. Some fire, that'll kill that cancer. Because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcraft, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcraft. That's talking about America. America is the well-favored harlot. You know what I'm saying? America, they selleth nations through her whoredoms. That's why this is what you call an empire. America don't went around the earth, done conquered nearly every nation on the planet. So they got a last few holdouts like Iran. They want to go up on Iran and conquer that shit. In Syria, that's why they up in Syria. They want to totally conquer and subjugate the Syrian people. Because they done ran through all the other nations, ran right through them, took all their resources, took all their gold, you know what I'm saying? And just ravished them. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts. And I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame. So yeah, this America's going to be brought to shame. Ain't going to be no more America when the Lord returns. Okay? It's going to be destroyed. And I will cast abominable filth upon thee and make thee vile, and will set thee as a gazing stock. Yeah, the destruction's gonna be so great, people's gonna be like, damn. That's how we're gonna be. We're gonna rejoice when we see the destruction. It's gonna be a gazing stock. When we get beat up in them chariots, we're gonna look down, you're just gonna see the fire. And you'd be like, damn, it looks beautiful.
Lake of fire.
And that shall come to pass that all they that look upon thee shall flee from thee and say, Nineveh is laid waste. Who shall bemoan her? When shall I seek comforters for thee? Yeah, because America is a modern day Nineveh. You know what Nineveh was in the ancient world, don't you? That was the kingdom that Nimrod established.
Nimrod.
You know Nimrod. Nimrod's, you know, behind the Tower of Babel. Built the Tower of Babel. He had a... He pretty much conquered the whole earth. He was trying to bring all nations. What Nimrod, America is pretty much following the same philosophies of Nimrod. They want to build a Tower of Babel. They want to bring all nations together in defiance of the Most High. And that's what America's about. That's why they call it a multicultural nation. They call it a melting pot. And what they're doing, they shipping all manner of people and all heathens from all nations and bringing them all in this country, mixing them all together. That's the same thing Nimrod did. Okay, so that, really America is the modern day Nineveh. It's the modern day, because that's the exact same thing Rome did. The Romans, the Babylonians, I mean, all these different nations, they all followed the same game plan as Nimrod.
Yeah, Book of Maccabees tell you about that, Greeks, yeah. Shit.
They all found, that's all the blueprint of Nimrod. The whole Christmas tree celebration, all this witchcraft, all goes back to Nimrod. You know what I'm saying? Back to ancient Sumeria, the lands of Cush, the lands of Nineveh. It all goes back to that ancient witchcraft. That's what for all that Freemasonry is based on. That's where you get the word New World Order. The what they call the dawn of a new day. So we're gonna have to go, Lord willing, soon we're gonna make a documentary on all the Illuminati symbolism up in this state house. There's a lot of it. Where was we at? Art thou better than populace? No. That was situate among the rivers, that had the waters round about it, and whose rampart was the sea, and her wall was from the sea. Oh, that's pretty much the point. We go to the rest of it. I'm gonna get back to the. I'm gonna get another precept. I'm gonna show y'all about this destruction that's coming. Yeah, I'm just gonna read all of this, man. It's a lot, but I'm gonna read it. Second Peter 3:3. Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers, walking after their own lust. Yeah, we know we living in the last days, all right? Knowing this, I already read that. And saying, where is the promise of his coming? That's what people say too, right? Jesus ain't never going. They call him Jesus. His real name's Yahweh Shai. They be like, he ain't never coming back. That Bible's some bullshit. Yeah. You know, they just running their lips, talking all kind of shit. Oh, there's like the scripture in the book of Psalms that the Lord said he gonna cut off your lips.
Sorry.
You know what that says? Like, I get it. It's like Psalms.
Psalms 12,
I think, maybe. The Bible, this is a real manly book. So all these churches, they teaching pretty, all these churches are really teaching Satanism.
Yeah.
They're pretty much devil worship. Totally, they're antichrist. Everything they teach is in opposition to the word of the Most High. I think it's 12. Psalms 12:1. Help, Lord, for the godly man ceaseth, for the faithful fail from among the children of men. They speak vanity, everyone with his neighbor. With flattering lips and a double heart do they speak. The Lord shall cut off all flattering lips and the tongue that speaketh proud things. I mean, that's as clear as clear. That's what the Lord just said that. That's in the Bible, okay? The Lord ain't no bitch.
Yeah, Yeah.
Cause that's a manly thing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's not a womanly, feminine thing.
Yeah.
That's, you know what I'm saying? The scriptures is for men, for manly men, not a, you know, little weak faggots. 2 Peter 3. Where was that? Damn.
I don't know.
That's how he threw a bottle at it. I'm gonna skip down here. 2 Peter 3 and 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment of perdition and ungodly men. So the Lord's gonna bring that great fire to this place. Because soon there's gonna be a third world war. The next world war is gonna be a thermonuclear war. And Vladimir Putin, he came out, he was bragging. He said he could destroy America in less than an hour.
That's the spirit. It's gonna be stored in the hour.
It's gonna be, that's the scripture in Revelation said that. Okay? Because America's gonna be, when the destruction come, it's gonna be destroyed in the length of an hour.
Look at these proud motherfuckers, man.
Y'all ain't gonna be proud. You ain't gonna have that proud look when you see those missiles coming out of the sky and you get your flesh getting devoured, your tongues melting, eyeballs melting in your sockets, yeah. Fingers on fire, you just turn into a pile of ashes. How much shit you gonna talk then? How are you gonna blaspheme the Lord when you turn into a pile of ashes? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Ain't gonna have that proud spirit on that day.
Base is gonna be fucking a base.
But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day with the Lord is as a thousand years, and a thousand years of one day. So yeah, because people are out. Oh, it's been thousands of years since the Bible was written. It's been 2 days since the New Testament was written. Yeah. 2 days. Yeah. And that's another way, you know, the Bible's the truth, because what year is it? It's the year, what it just turned, is 2016 A.D. Anno Domini, the year of our Lord. Because the time system, the year 2016 means it's 2016 years after the one they call Jesus Christ was born. So even time itself is based on the Lord.
Yeah.
So that's how you know the Lord is running shit. Obviously.
Most High ruler from the kingdom of men.
Yeah.
That's that Daniel right there. That's a badass scripture right there.
Said the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long suffering to us ward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Oh yeah, so that's why we out here teaching. To tell these fools to come to repentance. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because right now they walking in darkness.
Fucking idiots.
They walking in darkness. Let me get a scripture about that. Because most people, they walk around in darkness, okay? There's no light in them. Okay, they got no truth. They don't know nothing. Our people are uneducated. You know what I'm saying? They're all under a demonic spell. Pretty much, they walk around, they're under a spell. It's just like that damn movie, The Matrix. You know, motherfuckers are sleeping. You got to try to wake them up. But most people ain't gonna wake up. That's good. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I need to get John. Fingers are frozen. I got it.
Okay.
Remember I was telling you about how everyone's in darkness. John 3:17. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. And that word world means, you know, the cosmos, which means a orderly arrangement of things. Which means the nation of Israel. That's what it means. But he that believeth on him is not condemned. So if you believe on the Lord, you ain't going to be condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. That's it right there. These people, they love darkness rather than light. They'd rather live a life of darkness, a life of heathenry, than to walk in the light. You know what I'm saying? That's good, though. You know what I'm saying? They'd rather live among the rats and the roaches.
Yeah.
We get back to the Peter. Second Peter. Second Peter 3:10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that therein shall be burned up. So when the Lord comes, it's going to be a great destruction. Y'all seen that movie, The Knowing? They showed you that destruction in that movie. The whole earth, well, not the whole, they showed you America just getting burned up.
Yeah.
New York City got burned up just in a couple seconds. It was gone. All that years of work building that raggedy shit gone in a couple seconds.
Shall build, that fire, shall yeah, throw
they,
it down.
That, oh, we should get that. Yeah, the Lord, Esau, you shall build. They're going to get thrown right down. The Lord's going to destroy all these raggedy ass buildings. He's going to destroy all this garbage.
Piece of shit.
It's all going to be destroyed.
They built this shit in what, like 500 years? And then it's going to all be destroyed in fucking 1 hour. That's power right there.
Well, these, yeah, was, yeah, this whole, well, the whole continent, yeah, was colonized about, 500 years ago. But this, Columbus is fairly new, all these buildings. Yeah. So that, this one get destroyed even quicker than that.
Yeah. This shit is a piece of shit out here.
When did Ohio became a state in 1803?
Damn.
In 1803. Shit. And Lord willing, it's going to be destroyed soon.
Yeah.
Raggedy ass shit. Hey, these buildings are blasphemous. Hey, get that building on camera right there.
Which one?
That one, the Levesque Tower. You see that building, the Levesque Tower? That's a phallic symbol. That's we was talking about Nimrod. That represents Nimrod or Cyrus's penis. Yeah, it's a phallic symbol. It's an uncircumcised penis. And show that it has the shaft. I don't mean to talk like that, but to explain it. It has the dick. It's the penis with the balls and the testicles at the base. That building is designed to look like a big dick. It is. That's what it's a phallic symbol. I think it's called a Levesque Tower. They might have changed the name, though. And it's a phallic symbol. It's there to give honor unto their false gods. Because you know the story of Osiris. Said Osiris was what? He got chopped up into a bunch of pieces. And then Isis, the queen of heaven, went to find all of his pieces to put him back together. She found all the pieces except for his penis. So they say the phallic, you know, Osiris's penis has magical powers.
What the fuck?
That's why you'll see penises everywhere. That's why, the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C. That's a phallic symbol. That's Osiris's penis. Yeah. And they got the same thing at the Vatican. You see, the Vatican's supposed to be the home of Jesus. You know what I'm saying? Catholic Central. But they got a big-ass Egyptian heathen pagan monument right there, right in front of their main building. So they tell you they're a bunch of devil worshipers. The Pope worships Satan. The president's a high priest of Satan. Barack Obama worships. You got to worship. To be in the government, you got to be part of some Freemasons. You got to worship the devil. You got to be a homosexual. A lot of the politicians are pedophiles. And it's coming out. They be raping little boys. They be fucking young men. They get what they call pages. The senators have these, like, they get these young, like, interns. And they come up in their office. They be raping them and shit.
That's nasty.
That's what they do. They show you that in that Tom Cruise movie that was made by Stanley Kubrick, Eyes Wide Shut. Tom Cruise, Nicole Kidman. And they show you in that movie how all the pop people, all the powerful people of the society were in secret actually devil worshipers. Judges are devil worshipers in secret. Your principals, the principals at the schools, the politicians, the sheriffs, police chiefs, fire chief, you name it, any high ranking position in this society. To be a police chief, fire chief, school principal, a senator, you gotta worship the devil. They're all part of secret societies. They're all of them. That's how this whole world operates. It's like an underworld. And you got to know the language. You got to know the symbols. And if you don't know the language, if you don't know the symbols, you ain't going to see it. It's like in that movie Blade. You seen Blade, the vampire movie?
Yeah.
How they had vampire writing everywhere.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And you wouldn't know if that was a vampire place unless you could read the symbols.
Yeah.
It's the same. That movie was telling you something. Because here you can see all their satanic symbols everywhere. Just like that fucking face staring at us. Or any of this shit. We'll show y'all some. We'll make a video on some symbolism and show you what we're talking about. Well, Huntington Bank. Look at Huntington Bank.
Where?
Get the honey right here. That one right here with the green, the neon right here. Get that on camera. No, over here.
Oh.
The one with the light. See it?
Yeah.
It has a 6-point star in it. You see, it's a 6-point star, and that's the symbol that the so-called Jew, the head house of Esau uses. Because they're not real Jews. They're Edomites. They're devils. Okay? They use that 6-point star. And you can see that 6-point star also has 2 W's in it, ancient Hebrew W's. It looks like Y, it's 2 Y's.
Yeah.
It's actually a W, so it says 6-6. I mean, that's just one of them symbols. Because the so-called Jew owns them banks. They own that shit.
Yeah.
The so-called Jew owns this building. Look, Weiler. You see it? Well, yo, this is a Weiler. He must be running for office now. Can you see it up in the window?
Which one?
Over here, come here. Oh, you can't see it from here. Never mind. Yeah, but the so-called Jews own this whole city. That's a fact. They run this whole country, this whole planet. That's a fact.
They got all this Jew shit all over them.
Yeah, we're gonna get that. Lord willing, we're gonna make a video on that. They got a Jewish monument over here. It's too dark to look at it now. You know what I'm saying? We'll go over there and peek that, check that out. But there's symbols everywhere, man.
Yeah.
Well, they got the red shield. Check out U.S. Bank. They got a red shield. U.S. Bank. See that red shield? That goes back to the red shield of Rothschild. Rothschilds are the richest people on the planet Earth, okay? They make the money. They control all nations. And the Rothschilds, like I said, they're the richest family, and they're so-called Jews. They're Edomites. Because Esau, or Edom, means red, and Roth means red. Rothschild, it means red, red means red shield. And what do you have on that bank? You got a red shield. You see that? That's another one of them symbols. But your average retard can't read these symbols. Hey. These symbols have meanings. They don't just put random symbols up that don't mean nothing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're speaking a language.
Even Bloods and Crips do that shit on the walls.
Oh, yeah, they don't know what they're doing either. Yeah. You know what I mean? They're not educated in. The symbol, their symbols got meaning to them. If you don't read those symbols right, you could be fucked up, right?
Wrong hood.
You'd be in the wrong place at the wrong fucking time.
Shit.
You gotta. What's that Tupac song? Best to learn about the dress code, the B's and C's. You don't remember that?
No.
That's a Machiavelli. I don't listen to that bullshit no more. Let me get back to this, Peter. What was that read last? Oh, that was the point on that one, man. Yeah, because this whole America's gonna get burned up. This whole nation's gonna be burnt. It's gonna be totally destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you get even that nationwide symbol got the symbol of the eagle, don't it?
Where?
It ain't no big deal. That's the eagle of Jupiter. The eagle represents Jupiter or Zeus, the devil.
We got cross bronze sword.
What is it?
Bronze.
I can't even see what it is from here.
It's like it's a name of some type of Jew.
That's probably some lawyers or something. I'm gonna get some more of that fire before that. How much camp time? It's just probably about to die.
You got one bar left.
Bill.
Coda. PNC. Key Bank.
There's nothing but banks down here. There's bankers run this shit. And all the banks are owned by so-called Jews. That's a fact. That's a fact. And this whole country is ran on usury. the principle of usury, which means you lending someone money and then you charging them interest. And charging someone interest, that's against the laws of the Bible, okay? But this whole country is ran on that principle. And all these banks right here, they're all charging everybody usury. And they're all owned by the so-called Jew. And they know they're the kings of usury. They're the ones who started it. I got a scripture to back that up real quick. Usury. Like if you get a credit card, you got to pay interest on your credit card. That's against the laws of the Bible. If you late on a payment, they'll charge you interest. What's that saying? I can't think straight, man.
Nation riders on your side. Fuck that.
What's that?
Nationwide. Nationwide ain't on your side.
I said Revelation. I'm all messed up. Deuteronomy 23:19. Thou shalt not lend upon usury to thy brother. Usury of money, usury of victuals, usury of anything that is lent upon usury. And usury means charging interest. And that's what all these banks over here is doing. Huntington does it, U.S. Bank does it, PNC does it, Key Bank, number of banks around here. They're the ones running shit. So-called you running shit. Cause you ain't getting elected president unless the Wall Street bankers are backing you up. How do you think Obama got elected? He had all those Wall Street bankers backing him up, giving him all that money. Because if they don't give you money, you ain't getting elected. Because there's no such thing as an election, it's a selection. The presidential selections. You know what I'm saying? Most of them actually get groomed from their birth to be the president. Obama, he was groomed since he was a child to be president. They had that shit planned out years in advance. You know what I mean?
Ugly motherfuckers. Yeah.
Huh?
Okay. Say something. Grace.
Raggedy ass bastards. They got Huntington over there on that sign too. Get that on camera. They running shit. Look. Huntington. That's on the news building right there. What's that? Channel 10?
Yeah.
I guarantee you Channel 10 News is owned by who? The so-called Jews.
Yeah.
Hey, get on YouTube. If y'all watching this video, get on YouTube right now and type in the news is fake. The news is scripted. The news is scripted. Typed in the news is scripted. Just type that and you'll see what I'm saying. You'll see how all the news is fake. And they got video montages and video compilations showing how all the news stations be saying the exact same thing.
Shit. Yeah. I got the news thing. I forgot what news channel it was, but when that one shooting happened, that last shooting, they was like, here come the actors. Then he caught the dudes.
Oh, shit.
Like some dudes running out the building. What's that one shooting?
Yeah, a lot of them do. They got crisis actors on a lot of these shootings.
Yeah, same bitch, too. Same old raggy-ass looking bitch. Skinny-ass bitch.
Yeah, bitch. She done been seen in all kind of different shootings.
Yeah.
That's why we done drifted away from our bags.
Oh, shit.
We always, you be teaching me back and forth. Yeah. You drifted us.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
We drift all the way out in the street. Yeah, because all them mass shootings is all staged by the government. What's that latest shooting? What's that San Bernardino shooting? All the
California
witnesses of that San Bernardino shooting said they saw the gunmen were three white men. Okay, but the news is telling you it was Muslims. That was some government agents that went up there and killed all those people. Then they just got a couple retarded look of Muslims. You see how dumb they look? That is dumb as hell. And they got them to play the patsy. They look retarded.
How the fuck they gonna leave?
They was too retarded. They couldn't even pull that off. They was too.
How the fuck you gonna leave your bombs at home or some shit? Like,
shouldn't you use those bombs?
What you gonna do? Shoot the motherfucking place up and go home and get the bombs and go to a different place?
They got all those witnesses that said they saw three white men
wearing
tactical military gear.
Coughing on me, shit.
But they say those are not reliable witnesses because they was there. You know, and they'll say that, but they'll say because they was in a state of trauma and stress, and fuck so that when you're in a state of trauma and stress, you don't really see what you see.
Oh shit! Say that to a woman that getting raped.
She never forget that face. Like, that's why they have lineups after a crime happens, after someone gets robbed or beat up. They got a lineup. You identify them. Yeah. So man, get out here with that bullshit. Because that's actually what they said on the news. Because they was trying to debunk all the conspiracy theorists.
It's fucking retarded. Well, these people is retarded, actually. Yeah.
They are retarded.
That's actually kind of genius. It's kind of slick how they're doing it, but
it is
it's
slick.
Just the people that's just retarded.
They get
fuck.
On the radio or the news and they talk with a real smooth voice.
Yeah.
They're like, wow, these crazy guys on the internet, they say there's three white guys in there. They just...
Obama,
conspiracy theorists.
Obama trying to act like he's crying and shit.
It's like studies and science has proven that when you're under stress, you can never remember. They'll say that and they'll pull out scientific studies.
Wait a minute.
And they just make shit up.
Hold up. That's a lot. Well, because they, when you actually like, okay, say if you like scared spiders.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I just lost myself.
Yeah, okay.
And then like, what's happening? Shit, I can't remember. It's like they did like a little show on science or whatever. If you scared of spiders and like they damn, how can I say this? And like you know how you like show like different pictures like all fast and shit.
Yeah.
Like you'll notice that spider.
Somebody like that. You would know which one. You know that motherfucker. You ain't gonna forget that spider.
Without looking at, like you would notice that spider.
It's
in this
stuck
fast
in your
shit.
fucking psyche. It's ingrained in your mind.
You be like,
you ain't
forget.
If you see someone kill your father, you ain't gonna forget that man.
Yeah.
That man. Oh, what's that? What's that movie, The Princess Bride? When you do like, I'm a nigga Montoya, or something like that. You killed my father. Prepare to die. He ain't forget that motherfucker. He killed his ass.
Sorry. He go.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna forget no shit like that. So when you see a whole bunch of people get massacred in front of you, you ain't gonna forget those faces.
Yeah.
Those are the faces you will always. You will have dreams about them.
Another thing, I just want to say that, because like when people go to war, they have dreams about what they did, how they killed people.
They see the same soldier in their dream.
And they be like, every time I close my eyes, I always see that face.
Yep.
So what the fuck is these people talking about, man?
It's like in the other shooting, that Aurora, Colorado shooting. The Batman shooting. With the James Holmes shooting. The same deal went down there. The same deal happened. They said there were multiple gunmen wearing military gear that kicked in the doors.
Shit.
They were wearing military gear. But once again, they said the same thing. The witnesses are unreliable. They're under a lot of stress. And they see things. You see things when you're under that much stress. You know what I'm saying? So all these terrorist attacks you see on the news is all set up by the government just to take away your freedoms. That's what it's all about. The government was behind 9/11. Most people know that now. Y'all got YouTube. People, y'all got your Androids. Get on YouTube. Type in 9/11 inside job. They'll pop right up. Boom.
Shit.
If you don't know that by now, you gone. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of people waking up to that shit. That's why this. Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are sottish children. And they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge. That's our people, right? They say they're dumb as hell. Say, if you had the knowledge and the wisdom and the understanding of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shash, of the Lord, you ain't gonna get fooled. You ain't gonna get deceived. You know what I'm saying? Because we got a totally different outlook on the world. Because we got this truth. And we know that we're not ignorant of Satan's devices. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We know all about Satan's devices. But a foolish motherfucker, you gonna get fooled. That's why you called a fool, because you're easy to fool.
Yeah.
You a clown. You a goddamn clown. You know what I'm saying? You a joker. That's how Esau looks at you. Like, you so easy to fool. You believe anything. You're fucking gullible. You naive. You're foolish. And you got no light in you. The only thing you know how to do is just be evil.
Yep.
Just acting a fool all day, doing some dumbass shit, rap, walking down the street with your headphones on, rapping and dancing. You know what I'm saying? You see it every day, sagging all the way down to your fucking feet.
Yeah.
Why even wear pants? Your motherfuckers are wrapped around your ankles.
Yeah.
Just walk around in your boxers.
They gonna sag in that too.
They was. I mean, this is foolish, man. You see it every day. I see motherfuckers walking down the street rapping shit. I want to run them over.
What's the
I see whole women acting like whores on the street. Just run them over. I be praying a coda buster hit the curb, jump the curb, and squish you, man. You get pinned between two coda buses, right? That can happen right here.
Yeah.
You get it on camera. I pray you motherfuckers get pinned between the coda bus.
And then blow the fuck up.
And they flat you, you get squished. Yeah. If you in New York, I pray, if you want part of 2/3, like you live in New York, I pray someone pushes your ass in front of a subway train.
Yeah.
You just be chilling, checking your Facebook on this.
Yeah.
Waiting for the trip. Boom! Some crazy motherfucker come up and push you.
Ran over twice.
Yeah.
Trod him down, bitch.
So the Lord is crazy like that, man. He'll give you a cruel and unusual punishment.
Without remedy.
Yeah, without remedy. Did I read that scripture? I'll read that one. I did already read it. I'll read it again. That's a good I like that scripture. That'd be a good YouTube name, without remedy. Oh, someone's gonna take it now. That was fucked up.
I'm gonna change my name, dude.
Proverbs 29:1. Yeah, because this goes right in what we was just talking about. Proverbs 29:1. He that being often reproved hardeneth his neck shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. Yeah, because we out here reproving fools. You know what I'm saying? To reprove somebody, you're supposed to correct them. Because the Lord said to lift up thy voice like a trumpet and declared, I could get that real quick. I ain't brought that out in a minute.
They often reprove.
Isaiah. Huh?
So they often reprove because you got here every fucking week. Winter.
Yeah,
rain.
My fingers about to fall off.
That's often.
It's cold as fuck out here, ain't it?
Hell yeah.
You wearing multiple layers, it's still cold.
Yeah.
But you got clowns, man, claim to be teachers. They ain't scared to go out in the cold weather. Yeah. They like little girls, afraid of the. That's what some woman would say. It's too cold outside.
Yeah, what the fuck?
The woman was the first, you know, running to the car real quick, turning the heater on.
Well, she's struggling and shit.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Shivering, yeah. But they would do that Black Lives Matter shit.
A real man ain't gonna be scared of the cold, you know what I'm saying?
Or the hot, or the rain. Or snow.
Yeah, sleep. The rain. You don't want to get your hair wet.
Yeah. Get your dreads wet.
Get no dreads. You ain't supposed to have dreads. That's nasty. Yeah, you got a lot of them dudes at Nathaniel's in the IUIC got dreads and shit. Don't they?
Yeah.
But they claim they follow the law.
You motherfucker.
How you follow the law if you got dreads? Now, Paul said, Paul gave a commandment to the church, said you ain't even supposed to have long hair.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? What's up?
Nothing. I switch hands.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's gonna get cold, don't it?
Yeah.
We ain't got no gloves either. We come out ill prepared.
Jeez. Put your hands in your pocket, it works way better.
Put it in your fucking nuts. That keeps them the warmest. Your armpits? Your armpits or your crotch area? I mean, you want to stay warm, that's how you do it.
Yeah.
Pockets help a little bit. By Isaiah, we get this real quick. Isaiah 58:1. Cry aloud, spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet and show my people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. Because we only out here to teach the house of Jacob, the nation of Israel. We out here to wake up the lost sheep of the house of Israel. You know what I'm saying? Because our people have been scattered among all nations. So the Lord commanded us to come out here and wake these fools up. whether they hear, whether they forbear, we don't give a damn if they listen or not. We commanded to go teach them. The most people ain't gonna listen. They gonna just wish that we leave.
Yeah.
And I wish these motherfuckers would shut up. That's all they praying. Like, I can't take it no more.
Yeah. Motherfucker.
Like your boy that one day, Humpty Dumpty.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that nigga was crazy.
We was getting on his nerves so bad that he wanted to kill us. He actually, he's about to try to hurt us.
That motherfucker.
He's gonna crack his head open.
He probably don't remember.
Probably not. Hopefully he got killed by now.
Yeah.
Hopefully someone killed his ass. We got arrested and the cops fucking.
Yeah. And his wife too get killed.
Isaiah 58 and 2. Yet they seek me daily and delight to know my ways as a nation that did righteousness and forsook not the ordinance of their God. They ask of me the ordinances of justice. They take delight in approaching to God. Where, well, that's the point on that one. I just wanted to get that one out. Because that's a precept for that Proverbs 29 and 1. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to reprove these fools.
Yeah.
That's what you're supposed to come out. How you supposed to lift up thy voice like a trumpet if you ain't teaching?
Shit.
They say, but I'm on the internet, though. That's the electronic trumpet.
We ain't blowing my face.
Oh, yeah, this shit ain't no joke, boy. Hey, the scriptures say you got to teach on the highways and byways. Instant season, out of season.
Shit, you got to be like a soldier. This soldier's march in the winter. In the cold.
They live in the winter.
Yeah.
You live in the cold, boy. Yeah. I was in the Marines. We used to live outside for a lot. And that ain't nothing for maybe 2 weeks at a time. You outside without going inside.
Shit.
Sleeping under the stars.
Shit.
We didn't even use tents.
Shit.
We just had sleeping bags. Waterproof sleeping bags.
Yeah.
We didn't use tents because they was too heavy. It was better just it's just more weight in your backpack.
About bring you a horse. I don't give a damn. Put that on the horse. Bah.
You want to take as least shit as possible because whatever you take, you carry it. And you on foot. Yeah, your feet freezing. Toes freezing, just shivering. The worst is you wake up in the morning when you gotta get out that sleeping bag.
Oh, fuck that.
Fuck, yeah, it's cold as fuck outside. You gotta get out that motherfucker.
Damn.
God damn.
Yeah,
and you living out there. That's only, a woman can't handle that one.
Yeah.
She ain't gonna be able to make it through.
She gonna break down, though.
But now they putting women in infantry in all branches of service now.
That's fucking stupid.
How stupid is that? They gonna get you all slaughtered. That's good.
You gonna be screaming and shit behind enemy lines and shit.
Oh yeah,
fuck a black bitch.
Give away
in
your position.
Why he over here? Check me in.
Shit, she be the first one to turn into a traitor on your ass.
Yeah, she can't get tortured. Man, they gonna torture ass.
Everything.
Yeah.
It's easy to manipulate the women. That's why they allowed women to vote in America. Originally, women weren't allowed to vote. Or own property or anything else. They weren't allowed to run for office. That's not nothing bad about the woman. That's not her arena.
Yeah.
That's for the man.
Yeah.
That's a man's business.
It's been her life.
All the great kings of the history are all men. You know what I mean? All the great conquerors.
Yeah.
The great leaders are all men. What about Cleopatra? She got killed. She committed suicide.
Sorry. She gone.
She's out of there. She did not make it.
She gone. That bitch gone.
And she was an Edomite. And had a hook nose.
Ew.
She was a hook nose Jew.
Shit.
She was an Edomite.
I figured. What?
Well, Edomite Jew, you know. A Macedonian Edomite. Just like Ptolemies were Edomites. They were not Greeks. Because a lot of people are so stupid, they think that Cleopatra was a black woman. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When in reality, she was a white woman.
Because
the Macedonians, you know, they through Alexander, they conquered Greece. They conquered Egypt. And that was relatively early in history. Because their true ancient Egyptian empire had already been destroyed over 1,000 years before that raggedy bitch. During the Exodus, the Lord destroyed Egypt.
Sorry.
Yeah. That thing still going, is it?
Yeah.
That's lasting longer than I thought. I just charged it right before I came out. That's good.
God.
What was he talking about?
Damn.
The code?
Huh? Yeah.
Hey, the spirit just blew this page right open.
Yeah, 4 minutes.
Oh, look, the spirit just got this right here. Let's see if I can get to it. Ooh, I felt some wind go right in my back.
Yeah. You gotta turn your face on that. It's one of the Proverbs that says something about the code. I forgot.
All right, let me get this.
Sluggard.
Oh, this is that Matthew 24. You know, when it's, I'm just get to the, well, Matthew 24 and 4. And Yahawashai answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. That's what we're saying. We're saying the same thing the Lord said. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. You shall hear of wars and of rumors of wars, but be ye not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There shall be famines and pestilences, earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrow. So that's what we are saying. We've been talking, because World War III is about to come. What we got right now, wars and rumors of war.
Yeah.
Putin's talking shit, say he'd destroy America in an hour. He just said America and NATO is the number one threat to Russia's security. But it's all kind of wars going on. Russia is fighting in Syria. America's fighting in Syria. Turkey's in Syria. Iran's in Syria. You got Saudi Arabia about to fight Iran. You got wars everywhere. Libya just got fucked up. Iraq just got fucked up. What else is... Oh, you got... Don't forget about the war in Kiev. They don't be covering the Kiev fighting too much on the news. So there's wars everywhere. But I'm going to skip down to Matthew before this camera dies. Matthew 24 and 19. And woe unto them that are with child and to them to give suck in those days. Talking about these evil days that are coming. But pray ye not that your flight be not in the winter. Excuse me. Let me read that again. Pray ye that your flight be not in the winter, neither on a Sabbath day. This is cold out here. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck.
When that all hell breaks loose, it's going to be cold. Oh, the heat going to get turned off. The EBTs are going to get shut off. The heat's getting shut off. The electric's getting shut off. It's all getting shut down.
They're going to take your house.
They're going to take your house.
Peons are going to take
your house. They already taken everyone's property. They about to take everyone's guns. Obama's just passing orders. They're going to start taking all everyone's guns. It's going to be a wrap. It's going to be a total lockdown.
Start taking your children.
Yep, they already taking people's children. But the children's services will take all your children.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Your baby's mama will take your children.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
You know
up.
What I'm saying? She could be a hoe and there's nothing you can do about it. We live in Satan's kingdom.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
That's totally against the ordinances of the Lord. Child support is nowhere to be found in the Bible. The Bible says if a woman leaves a man that she gets nothing. She don't even get the children. So this country is backwards as hell. They'll lock you up if you don't pay child support. And you know when you pay child support, the woman, she wasting all the money. She ain't buying them kids nothing. They run around in the middle of the street with no shoes, playing in broken glass, boogers all up in their nose, doo-doo in their diapers, just diapers sagging down to their knees.
Yeah, that bitch buying weed.
She buying weed. She get that child support check. That's that party check. She buying pills, getting her weed.
What this bitch does buy some chicken.
Buy some chicken.
eat chicken every fucking day while she living lavishly and shit.
No, I see, man, over there in the apartments we was living.
I be like, what the fuck?
With all the little kids every day. Yeah, I'm not trying to hear gangs of little kids in this house, these apartments I lived in. And they all run around wild as hell outside in the streets, no clothes on, shit in their diapers. They out in the middle of the street, young as hell. Mom is nowhere to be found. Because not a single one of them have fathers.
Sorry.
You know what I'm saying?
Sorry.
And I bet you they all getting them child support checks, getting those EBTs. Getting that Section 8.
Yeah.
And then soon they gonna shut all that shit off.
I need Section 8, you know what I'm saying? Hey. I need motherfucking EBT.
And a woman can't, they ain't gonna give a man Section 8. They ain't gonna give that to a man. It ain't gonna happen. Because the government wants to keep the man down, because that's the power. They don't want the men revolting against the power. They want to keep all the men in slavery. That's why we got all these Aunt Jemima ass bitches. You know what I'm saying? Their job is to keep the men down. But they putting women in all kind of positions of power. You go to the BMV, none but women working cussing at your ass.
Yeah.
That's totally out of order. You go to the schools, All the teachers of schools are mostly women. Yeah. You notice that?
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a man teaching a man, not a woman. That's totally backwards. How could a